Welcome friends to One Stop Java Solutions. I am Sneasis and today I am going to explain the rest of the part of if else statement. Okay. So in the previous video I have explained that the syntax of the if else and how you will use. Okay. So today I will also explain the nested ifs and as well as if else if ladder statement. Okay, so here you can see the means you can use the multiple statement, okay, as a block of statement you can associate with if, and similarly with else also you can associate multiple statements. Okay, so here suppose statement 3 is only there, so you can add more statement. Okay, statement 4. So 3 and 4 is associated with the else and 1 and 2 is associated with the if part. Okay, so here the you know that if this if is set, means condition is satisfied, means if this block execute, this block of code will execute, then the else part will not execute. Okay, so this part will not execute. And also if this part is not execute, means if statement is not satisfied or it returns a false, then this part will not execute. So in that case the else part will execute. Okay, and after that if you write something else, that part will execute normally by sequence, in sequence, means one by one. Okay, and in case of nested if, okay, you have to understand what else is associated with what if statement. Okay, so it is clear that the else statement always associate with its immediate if or nearest if. Okay, so here you can see this is if, and the else is always should be always associate with this if. Okay, so else always associate with the immediate if statement. Okay, and in between if and else there should be no other statement. Okay, so no other statement means either there should be only one statement or block of statement that should be separated with an opening and closing curly brace. Okay, so this is what in between these curly braces or a single statement there should be no other statement. So in case of nested if, suppose I am writing code, I am removing this. So here I am int marks. Suppose I am giving the 85. Okay, and I am writing here if marks greater than 90. Then I am printing grade 1. Okay, grade suppose A. Okay, and here I can, using only if you can do it, if marks greater than 90 then grade A, if marks greater than 85. If I write like this way, if, okay, copy this one, if marks greater than equal to suppose 80 then grade B. So if you like this way, then what is the, so what is the problem here if you run this code? So here you can see, so this is not satisfied, this part is satisfied, so it will print this. And like this way, if marks greater than 70 then it's also print grade C. Okay, and now if I run, if you run this, so here you can see B and C both are came as input. This should not be the situation. So if it's 85 then it should be only means in between 80 and 85, so grade B would be, should be the grade. Okay, so to do this you can use, so this is if, okay, so that is the nested if. And here also means if there is a multiple situation, suppose if marks greater than 90 and there is some like attendance, okay, if marks greater than 90 and I am giving attendance in days, suppose 75, okay, and I am checking if marks greater than 90, and inside that if attendance greater than suppose 70, if the condition is like that, if marks should be 90 and attendance, if attendance greater than 70, then it will print only grade A. Okay, similarly in the second statement also, if marks greater than 80 and attendance greater than 70, then it will print the 70. Okay, and if you run this code, then also you can see B and C, and here also you can write the same. Okay, so here you can see the B and C. So this is the nested if, means if inside there is another if condition. So you can merge these two using the AND statement. So instead of writing this if, so here you can write like this way: if marks greater than 90 and attendance greater than 70, means if more than one statement. So instead of nested if, you can use like this way: and attendance greater than 70, then it will print. So it means if both these two conditions satisfied, then it will print this. Okay, so this is the means instead of, so you can write this way as well. So if marks greater than 80 and if attendance greater than 70, then it will print something. So that is means nested if, means if inside an if. Okay, so that is the nested if. And similarly using, so here also you can see there is a drawback, means in means if you have to print certain marks, okay, there, and there is some condition that if marks greater than suppose 70 or 80, then it will print some grade. Okay, so in that case you cannot use like this way, means nested if, only nested if you cannot do. So in that case you have to do if else if ladder. So how you will do, so if marks greater than 90 and attendance 70, then eta. Else, so that means if this situation already satisfied, means first statement execute, then rest of the if else will not execute. Okay, so else if marks greater than 70, I am merging these two instead of nested if, I am writing here and attendance greater than 70, then it will print eta. And here also I am writing else if marks greater than 70 and attendance greater than 70, then it will print C. So now you can see it will either print B or C, okay, whatever is means not B. So it is now here the same code, it will give the B. So that means I am using if else if ladder. Okay, so if this condition satisfied, then rest of the part will not execute. Okay, and suppose first part is not executed, okay, first part is not executed, then it will come to this else. Okay, and check if this condition satisfied, if this condition satisfied, then this part will execute and rest of the part will not execute. Okay, and suppose this also not satisfied, then it will come to the third part. Okay, it comes to this part and it will check if this is satisfied, then this will execute. And if nothing satisfied, then it will means if any condition not satisfied, then nothing will execute. Okay, so it will give you blank. Okay, so this is the if else if ladder. And for nested if also, there is a means important thing I am writing here. Suppose if okay, I am writing only marks. If marks greater than 80, if marks greater than 80, then suppose in nested if, what means you can use multiple ifs. Okay, if marks greater than 80, if marks suppose equal to 85. Okay, so first I am checking if marks greater than 80, then marks equal to data, then I am printing something. Grade suppose A. Okay, so this got this. Okay, so if marks greater than 80 and there is a nested if, else I am printing something. Let's see. Else grade B. Okay, so and here I am writing here a bracket and here I am giving else grade suppose C. It's fine. So here you can see this is a nested if. So if there is inside if and here I am using else. So this else is immediate else of this if. Okay, so the immediate means nearest if. Okay, for this else, this is the nearest if. Okay, so this is the else statement of this. And else if marks greater than 80. So here you can see this is a block of statement and this else is the nearest else of this if. So this else is the if associated with this if. And this else is associated with this if. Okay, so this is also okay. So if you run, it will give some output grade A because here marks you have given the marks is 85. So here it will check marks greater than 80 is true. Marks greater than 80, then it will check the marks is 85. Okay, so if this is satisfied, then this else will not execute. Okay, and if this is not satisfied, so if you give the suppose marks is 75. And then if you execute this, so you will give this code. Okay, and here also it's instead of 85, if you give it's suppose 88, so then this line will execute. Okay, here you can see this line system.grade is B. So here you can see in first case, if you give the marks is 85, then it will check marks greater than 85, yes true. Then it will check if marks equal to 85, yeah. If marks equal to 85, then it will print grade A. If marks not equal to 85, then it will print this line. Okay, and if this satisfied, if this condition satisfied, then this else, outer else will not execute. Okay, and if this if else not satisfied, then it will not enter into the block of code. Okay, then it will directly come to this else and it will print this else. Okay, so this you have to understand what else is associated with what if. Okay, that thing you have to understand. Okay, for nested if else. Okay, and for if else if ladder, you can overcome that I already explained. Means in case of marks, if any statement execute inside any if statement and you don't want to execute rest of the statement, in that case you have to use if else if ladder. Okay, but here if the first this if execute, if this if execute, then it will come to the second if. Okay, and subsequently if there is any other if statement is there, so that part also execute. Okay, so in that case you can use the nested if. Okay, so hope it's you can understand. Okay, so thanks for watching this video and also subscribe my channel to get notification. And for the previous video, you can see the link in the description box. So just click on it and go there and watch it. Thanks for watching this video.